Good morning. It's Wednesday, June 26, 2019. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, The Power of a Curse, and our scripture is Psalm 59. For the choir director, a psalm of David regarding the time Saul sent soldiers to watch David's house in order to kill him, to be sung to the tune, Do Not Destroy. They come out at night, snarling like vicious dogs as they prowl the streets. Listen to the filth that comes from their mouths. Their words cut like swords. After all, who can hear us? They sneer. But Lord, you laugh at them. You scoff at all the hostile nations. You are my strength. I wait for you to rescue me, for you, O God, are my fortress. In his unfailing love, my God will stand with me. He will let me look down in triumph on all my enemies. Don't kill them, for my people soon forget such lessons. Stagger them with your power, and bring them to their knees, O Lord, our shield. Because of the sinful things they say, because of the evil that's on their lips, let them be captured by their pride, their curses, and their lies. Captured by your own pride, curses, and lies. What an incredible minefield in which to walk. What human being isn't trapped by his own pride? Who among us hasn't uttered an idle curse, either with his lips or his heart? Has there ever been anyone but Jesus who never lied? We live in an age where truth has gone begging. What has replaced simple truth is obscenity, invective slurs thrown at each other. It's a mudslinging contest with the prize of this culture awarded to the vilest potty mouth. I do believe my mother would have run out of mouth-washing soap. Jesus did not have a single word of praise for such. However, the Lord did pass a searing word of warning about how we use words, Matthew chapter 12. And I tell you this, you must give an account on Judgment Day for every idle word you speak. Now, if an idle word can get you in trouble on Judgment Day, imagine what judgment will happen for the mean-spirited nastiness that floods like a torrential downpour from the mouths of people in everyday life. Paul understood the difference between vile language and helpful language. In Acts chapter 9, the apostle is breathing out words of death and destruction to Christians, followed by the deeds of oppression and execution. In a heartbeat, Paul's soul is converted when he met Christ, and the conviction that brought down the enemy of Jesus and his church becomes the instrument of building up that same church he persecuted. Now here's good advice from this once foul-mouthed Pharisee who'd learned how to clean up his act and his mouth. Ephesians chapter 4. Don't use foul or abusive language. Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement for those who hear them. For you today, a little more advice from a formerly trenched-mouthed apostle of doom who had learned what really should proceed from our lips. He learned that if you want good stuff to come out of your mouth, you need to fill the heart with that good stuff, because that's where all the words have their birthplace. Philippians 4:8. And now, dear brothers and sisters, one final thing. Fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable and right and pure and lovely and admirable. Think about such things that are excellent and worthy of praise. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.